And right now, we're at UC Riverside in a building that bears your name. So clearly, you've been very involved with education in this valley. Can you tell us why education is so important for Coachella Valley students?
It's important for everybody. At the turn of the last century, a man lost his son to a disease when the son was 18. And that father was in the railroad business, and he tried to give Harvard University a grant to build a building in his son's name and teach Western history. And Harvard would take the money, but they wouldn't agree to let him determine what was going to be taught. So he said, well, the heck with that, I'm going to go build a school out in California. So he went to Palo Alto, and he named the school after his son, Leland Stanford. When Stanford went in, it changed all of America, because that's Silicon Valley. And when MIT went in the East Coast, Route 128, the University of Texas in Austin, Austin is now a hotbed of development for semiconductors and high tech. If you look at where all of your development of new processes and ideas come from, it's always from college towns. You know, you're not going to find it in Detroit. You know, you're going to find it in Chicago, where the college towns are. So if you look at a community, it always develops around education. Kids are going to settle where either they're from or where they went to college. I mean, that's where they're going to start. So if you want to change the valley, if you want the valley to be more entrepreneurial, then bring education here. Start teaching kids here. I mean, look, I'm from Des Moines, Iowa. Happiness was Des Moines, Iowa in my rearview mirror. You know, so if you come to California, if you come to school in the desert, why wouldn't you stay? And if you are an entrepreneur, like a lot of people involved with you, Ernie is one of them, if you're an entrepreneur, then you stay and you develop and business grows. So, you know, the whole idea of education is the base for everything that happens in this country. How many grade school graduates develop semiconductors? Not many. You don't develop semiconductors, you don't develop software, you don't develop businesses unless you get an educational background that allows you to do that. So I think that as Cal State Bernardino starts to expand, as UC Riverside starts to expand, as you know, 20 years from now, this will be a giant campus, and there'll be every year graduates that graduate, go into the community, start businesses, employ people, build technologies. That's how it starts.